Hey, hi everyone, this is Bakka Pachinchalkar. Welcome back to Test Automation Tool Selenium. In this video session, we will talk about how to handle frames or iframes in Selenium WebDriver. Let us jump to the high level agenda for the today's video session. First, we will discuss what is this iframe or a frame, and we will discuss how to create your own iframes or frames, and different ways of accessing the frames or iframes in Selenium WebDriver. And the fourth point is how to switch between the frames or iframes in Selenium WebDriver. And finally, we will discuss how to count the number of iframes or iframes in the particular web page. Well, let us jump to the topic. What is this iframe is? This iframe is nothing but inline frame, is an HTML document embedded inside the another HTML document on the website. The iframe HTML element is often used to insert the content from another source such as advertisement into the web page. This iframe will be configured with its own scroll bar independent of the surrounding space scroll bar. And we'll discuss what is this iframe and how we can create your own iframes. This is a very simple syntax. Just I have given one example here. You have to use the iframe tag and you have to define the source for that iframe, and after that this width and the height you have to specify. These are the mandatory fields for this iframe. So if you want, you can define name of the iframe or ID of the iframe, and after that you have to close this iframe tag. That's it. And we'll discuss different ways of accessing to the frame or iframe in Selenium WebDriver by using the name of that frame or an ID. You can switch to the particular frame, and the second one is you can use the index, and by using that index you can switch to the particular frame. And third one is by using the web element locator you can switch to the particular frame. Let us jump to the web page. For the demo purpose, I have created one small HTML code and I have placed it in my system. So this is not a web application, actually this is a simple HTML code I have written for a demo purpose. Let us look into this page source. See here, I have created one HTML tag, under that on body tag, at the end I have closed it. Under the body tag I have defined three frames, that is our first frame, and this is the second frame, and third one is third frame that does not contain the name of the frame and the ID of that frame. So that's it. This is a simple script I have written for the HTML. This is the actual page. This is the first frame and this is the second frame. This one is the third frame, and this link is just I have created in the HTML code, like in the parent window some content should be there. For that, how to switch and how to perform activities on the parent window and as well as a particular frame. So first I'll tell you the scenario. With respect to that, we'll write a Selenium automation script. First we'll launch the web browser, and after that we'll enter this URL, and we'll switch to this particular frame, and we'll perform one click operation. You can perform your own operation. Just for the demo purpose, just I'll click on this download button, and after that I'll navigate to this parent window and I'll click on this hyperlink. That's it. And after that we'll close the browser. Let us jump to the Eclipse ID. Quickly I create one test case, that is of type test engine test case. Here I need to mention the name of the class. So here I'm mentioning iframe as a class name, and I click on finish button. So here you go, you got a new class. So just here, just I'll rename this F with the test case one. What I'll do is first I'll write quickly three lines of code that launches me the web browser of type Internet Explorer. So here I'm writing web driver dot Internet Explorer driver dot driver, and after that you have to pass the .exe file for this. So I have .exe file in my computer in this location. So just I'll paste it here. I'll take this entire name of fully path of this .exe file, and I'll paste it. Here you can use a single forward slash or two backward slash. So here I'm using two backward slashes in this video session. That's it. And put a semicolon at the end of the statement. And after that, what I'll do is I'll create a Internet Explorer driver object. And I'll assign to the web driver type. That's it. Just import the related packages, and after that I'll use the driver reference variable. I'll call to the get method. Here you have to enter the URL of that page. So here I have URL for that, actually that is HTML.html document. So I have placed it in my system. Just I'm giving the path of that. You have to give the entire fully path of that .html file. So here you can use a single forward slash or same case like you have mentioned the .exe file for Internet Explorer browser. That's it. We have opened the browser and we have entered this particular URL. After that, what we have to do is we have to navigate, or we have to switch to this particular frame, and you have to click on this download button. So for that, what I'll do is first I'll use a driver reference variable, and I'll call to the switch to method. After that, you have to switch to that particular frame, right? So you have to call to the frame method here. Here you can see the it takes integer type of argument and the string types of argument, and the third one is a web element type. So here I'll select string type. So I'll mention the name of the frame. Just now I have discussed different ways of accessing to the particular frame. So here I'm mentioning the first. I'll discuss how to access particular frame by using the name. So in this case, when you just you open your Firebug and select here the HTML tag and select any inspect any element in this particular frame which you want to access or which you want to perform any activities on the iframe. So here I'm inspecting the elements from the iframe number 2. So I need a name of this particular frame, right? So just to go up here, just minimize this. When you hold your mouse on the iframe, it is highlighting that particular iframe. So you need a name of that frame. So just take the name of that frame and put a semicolon at the end of the statement. Now I have switched to this particular frame. So now I can perform a required operation on this particular frame. So I want to perform click operation in on this particular element. So here I'll take the XPath of this particular web element. So here I got XPath of that particular element. So I'll find that element by using the XPath, and I'll call to the click operation that clicks on that particular web element. And after that, I need to switch to this particular parent window. I wanted to perform click operation in this particular hyperlink. So for that, you have to use the same method, switch to dot default content. This statement that takes you to the parent window in the web page. That's it. Now you can perform your required operation on the web element. So just inspect in FightPath this particular web element. Just take this XPath. This is not a reliable XPath, just for the demo purpose, just I'm taking it. Here I'm finding that element by XPath here. So I'll perform click operation on that particular hyperlink, and then I'll close the web browser. That's it. Let us execute this Selenium automation script. Yes, it is launching the web browser. And after that, it has entered the URL which you have specified in the get method. After that, it should perform click operation in this particular download method. Yes, it is performing click operation in that particular element. After that, it should click on this hyperlink. And after, yes, it is clicking on that particular hyperlink. Yes, it is going to the my channel. There I have specified the URL of that my channel. So it's going to the particular URL. It should close the browser. Yes, it is closing the web browser. That's it. This is the one of the way you can switch to the particular iframe or a frames in Selenium WebDriver, and you can perform any activities on the web elements. Next one I'll discuss is by using the index, how you can switch to a particular iframe or a frame in Selenium WebDriver, and you'll perform the same activities. Just I'll comment this line of code. Just I'll copy this line of code again. I'll paste it here. So second one we'll discuss. Just I have discussed three ways of accessing the frames, or three ways of accessing the frames, or you can switch to particular frames by using those three methods. So second method is by using the index, how you can switch to that particular frame. So always index starts with the zero. So here, if you want to perform any activities on the any of the frames, suppose say, let us say I want to perform same activities on the same frame. So for in this case, this is a zeroth frame. This is a first frame, this is the second frame. If I want to perform any operation on this first frame, so I need to enter index as a one here. So it switches to this particular frame again. It performs click operation on this particular download link button. Then it will close the web browser. After that, it navigates to this parent window, and after that it clicks on this hyperlink, and it will close the browser. Let us execute this script by using the index of that frame we have switched to that particular iframe. So let us execute this test script. Yes, it is launched the browser, and after that it has entered the URL. Yes, it is clicking on this particular button C, and after that it is clicking on this hyperlink, and after that it is navigating to the my YouTube channel. Yes, it should close the web browser. That's it. Yes, it is working as expected. The third way of accessing to particular frame is by using the web element. So just let me comment this entire line of code. So we will navigate, or we will access this particular frame by using the web element. Not for this frame, you will access to, if you don't find any, let me show you the HTML code for this. For this frame, in some situation, if you don't find any name or ID of that particular frame, so you have to use the web element. By using the web element, you can switch to that particular frame. So in this case, that's why I have took this particular iframe. So I have not defined anything name or ID of that particular frame. So in this situation, how you can switch to this particular frame, that is the frame number third, and you can perform your activities. So by using the, by writing the XPath for this iframe, you can switch to the particular frame. So here what I'll do is, first I'll find element, that is the iframe, by XPath. So for this I'll write an XPath and I'll store this into the web element, and I'll give a element as an argument for this iframe. That's it. First I'll take the XPath for this particular frame. So just go to the Eclipse, sorry, Firepath. Here I'll write a simple XPath. If you don't know how to write the custom XPaths, I have created in the beginning of this Selenium video sessions. Just go through once, and if you find any difficulties, let me know. Same thing I am using here. For this thing, I need to specify the tag name here. For this is iframe tag. So here I am typing iframe tag. Sorry, iframe. Here you have one element called title. By using the title attribute, I'll write the XPath. So here you have to define @, and you have to define the attribute name equal to, in the single quotation you have to mention the attribute values. So here in this case it is home page value for this title attribute. So here I'm writing home page. That's it. Yes, just hit enter. It will highlight this uniquely, highlights this particular web element. Sorry, that's iframe. So take this XPath, just paste it here, and I'll store this into the web element type. That's it. What I'll do is just import the related packages. That's it. So I'll use the same syntax how you are switching by using the name of the frame or index of that particular frame, you are switching to the particular iframe, right? Same syntax I'm using. Instead of index or a name of the frame, I'll pass web element type. That's it. So here I'll take this XPath of this particular. So we are performing activities on this frame number third, right? So I'll take XPath of this particular element. I want to perform click operation on this particular web element. So it is the same XPath. I think it is similar to the previous XPath. Just paste it here. and same activity will continue, but the thing is we are using web element type and we are switching to the particular iframe by using the Selenium WebDriver. So let us run this script. Yes, it is launching the web browser. After that, it has entered the mentioned URL. It should perform activities on this particular third window. There is a third iframe. So it is clicking on this particular link, and after it should click on this particular YouTube channel, that is a hyperlink which I have created for the demo purpose. Yes, it is navigated to the proper page. It should close the web browser. That's how you have to work with the all the frames which you are dealing with the in your application. Firefox has a one good feature. See, if you say for example, if just check to the this HTML tab and inspect any element here. See here, it is highlight, it is giving the option as frame number 2. When you select any elements from frame 3, it is going to that particular frame. So just click on this drop down icon. Here it will find you are in which frame you are, like how many frames exist in this particular web page. I have 3 iframes and I have 1 parent window. So if you inspect any element from the parent window, instead of this iframe, it will get selected as top window. That is nothing but parent window. By using this also, you can identify the any iframes or exist in the web page. Finally, we'll discuss how to count the number of iframes in the web page. So what I'll do is just I'll comment all these operations that takes the time. So let me write one statement: driver dot find element, not find element, find elements here by dot. I'll use a tag name for that. Tag name is a very unique name for identifying any iframes or frames in Selenium WebDriver. So here I'm taking the tag name. Just I'll simply specify the name of that tag, that is called iframe. That's it. This returns me the set of elements. So I'll store it this into the web element type. Equal to element. So this returns me the list of elements because I'm calling to the find elements. So you have to store this into the list type. So just I'm converting web elements into the list type. Just import the related packages. That's it. If you have a list of elements, finding the size of that list is not a big deal. So that can be done by using the size method. So just take the element reference variable, you call to the size method, that returns me the how many elements exist in this particular list. So let me put into the some format, total number of iframes is, that's it. Let me execute this script. It should return me the total number of iframes is 3 actually, but it should return me the 3 iframes. Wait for the second. So yes, it is launched the browser, and after that it see here you can, total failures is 0 and the total test run is 1 and that is passed. It is printing me the total iframe exists in the application is 3. That's all I have in this video session. I think I have covered almost all the topics which I listed in this video session. What is iframe array, frame array iframe in Selenium driver, and how to create your own frames and different ways of accessing frames or iframes in Selenium driver. And after that we have discussed how to switch between the iframes or frames, and finally we have discussed how to count number of iframes in the web page. If you can try the same at your end. If you find any difficulties, you can drop me an email and you can send out a WhatsApp message. Please do subscribe, like and share these videos. Thanks for watching.